So, what is the role of a godly parent? Just like last week, right? We learned about how we can be a godly wife. So, we all have roles to play. As a wife, we have to submit, to be a helpmate, to support our husband. Doesn't mean that we are lower than our husband, but that's our role. And now we learn what is our role as a godly parent. And so being a parent truly is a great privilege. Not everyone has this privilege to be a parent. Even though you don't have biological parent or child, if you are taking care of children, you can consider to be their second parent as well. So it's a sacred trust from the Lord, meaning it's not that we own these children that is entrusted to our care, but rather we are like being entrusted a precious gem, a precious asset that we have to take care and do our role in how to parent them, because it's a privilege. In Genesis 1:28, we are told that God blessed them and said to them, to Adam and Eve, no, be fruitful, increase in number, fill the earth and subdue it. So yes, we are commanded to be fruitful, no? And not only be fruitful, but make sure you also subdue it, meaning we need to take care of it. Psalm 127:3-4, sons are a heritage from the Lord. Children are a reward from Him. Like arrows in the hands of a warrior are sons born in one's youth. So our children, our sons and daughters are our legacy, our inheritance from the Lord. So let's pag-iingatan. We have to take care well, because they are precious treasures that God has entrusted to us. So just like a school, no, when you entrust your kids to, like, for example, Wisdom Light, they are precious. We know that we have to take care of your child, of our students, because they are gifts from God that you entrust to us for a few hours every day to educate them. So children, we should treat our kids that they are like arrows in the hand of a warrior, our sons born in one's youth. Yes. So, and then we are reminded in Psalm 24:1, the earth and everything in it, the world and its inhabitants belongs to the Lord. They are not ours, but God's. So, yes, we love our children. God loves them more than we love our children. His perfect and wonderful plans for them is to prosper them, not to harm them. So as parents, let's co-work with the Lord. Let's depend on God as we parent our children. Yes, we are not on our own. The battle is the Lord's. Our children is His. Yes.